Hello everyone, hi, welcome to the channel of Wall Street Mojo. If you are new to this channel, then don't forget to subscribe this channel and there's a bell icon that's given below. Today we have a topic with us is called mode. Mode function is again a statistical function. We'll try and understand this topic in a much more detailed format. Let's understand the nitty-gritty of this topic first. See, mode function is basically categorized as the, as I told you, statistical function in Excel. So in mathematical terms, the mode returns the mode for a given data set. Now, the mode in Excel returns the most often occurring or repetitive value in an array or a range of data will also be seen. Here, if you start with mode and just write is equal to mode. This function is available for compatibility with 2007 earlier. It returns the most frequently occurring or repetitive value in array. Okay, so it shows us two number. In mode, mode formula has following parameters, number one and then number two. Well, number one, it is the array of the number parameter or a set of one or more numeric values for which we want to calculate the mode. And second, it is an array of optional parameters. Now, how to use mode function in Excel? Very important. Let's learn this. See, mode function in Excel is very simple and it's very easy to use. So let's understand the working of the mode function by some example. Mode formula can be used as a worksheet function and as a VBA also. What we will do is that we'll directly jump on the example so that you will have a clear idea of what we are talking about. Now let's consider a given set of numbers and we have to calculate the mode formula in Excel of them and then apply the mode formula on the given values as shown in the table. Okay, we'll start with saying is equal to mode. Here, select this and then select the whole data, close the bracket. We have 15 as a part of our answer. So this is the mode. Example number two here. Let's consider the given set of values here. There are two logical values here in the given data set. Now apply the mode formula here. The mode function ignores all the logical values and returns the output. See, this is the logical values, right? So it will eliminate that. Is equal to, let's write mode. Select the whole data. You have answer as 15. Next, example number three. In mode formula example, we have a data set with non-numeric values, empty values and zero in the data. So mode function simply, it simply ignores the non-numerical value, empty value, but considers zero as the value and provide the most repetitive value from the given set of data as it is shown here. So we'll say is equal to mode, select the whole output. It will ignore the text. Again, it will show us 15. Data set remains the same. Just a couple of things have been changing here and there. Example number four. Now, here are a couple of numbers that is given to us. In mode formula example, we have a given set of data in the horizontal table and we apply the mode function to get the most repetitive values from the given data. Here, we'll take the output part and that will be is equal to mode and take the number from G3 to L3. Close the bracket. Control D and we have all the sets of output here, right? It directly, you know, copies down the whole formula by doing Control D. Now, see, remember one thing, mode function can be used as VBA also. And, you know, that is also a part of this. Again, remember one thing, this examples over here is similar to what we have done. But now I'll make you understand that there are some things you know, you should know about the mode function in Excel. See, arguments can either be number or probably names or arrays or references that contains number. So if an array or reference argument contains text, logical values or empty cells, the values are ignored by the function. However, any cell with the value zero are included. And arguments that are error values or text that cannot be translated into numbers, it causes errors. The mode functions through, if you see for the num error, if there are no duplicate or repetitive value in the supplied data sets, hence there is no mode within the supplied value. And, you know, if you just try and make things work over here as, let's say, we'll just try and go for is equal to mode. Copy the data from A28 to A32. And we will get as NA as the answer. So the mode function value, as I told you before also, we will have over here the second set of thing that should be learned for this particular function. See, the mode functions through value error, goes through a value error when a value that is supplied directly to the mode, N is non-numeric and also is not a part of an array. So non-numeric functions that are in the array of values are ignored by the mode function. So you can just type is equal to mode and then copy the whole data, close the packet. Or after this, just write comma, the external value that you are writing. Let's say HDD. It will say value error. Right. So these are the couple of things that you should remember. In a nutshell, argument can either be number or name or arrays or references that contains numbers. If an array or reference argument contains text, logical values, text, this a logical value, this are text, okay, or empty cell like here, this ones, the values are ignored by this function. However, any cells within value 0 are included. Arguments that are an error value or text that cannot be translated to numbers causes error like this. The mode functions, you know, also will be having some num error if there are no duplicates repetitive values in the supply data sets, and hence there is no mode with the supplied value. So I hope you have got a fantastic idea and a good understanding about this function, a statistical function of mode. If you have learned and enjoyed watching this video, please like, comment on this video and subscribe to our channel for all the latest updates. Thank you, everyone.